didn't deserve this. I was an innocent bystander minding my business, and now I'm in here like this, in a damn near a walking body bag.
Wow, very powerful there, breaking her silence from her hospital bed, a story you'll see only here on WLWT. 5 days after she was hit by a police cruiser, she is now speaking out.
Yeah, and she has a message tonight for the officer who put her in the hospital. WLWT News 5's Brian Hamrick has the exclusive interview for us tonight. Brian.
Yeah, well, Natalie Cole is speaking from her hospital bed this evening. She says she is in a lot of pain, but you might be surprised what she's saying about the officer who hit her.
And I am a child of God, so I can't say that I wish the worst on this man.
Despite more than 100 stitches in her head,
my spine is fractured,
and a long list of broken bones,
my pelvic is broke, my hip is broke.
Natalie Cole is not seeking revenge against the man who injured her.
He needs help, and he needs to recognize that he does. Before somebody else dies or get hurt from this.
Natalie was hurt after she was hit by a police cruiser driven by Cincinnati officer Orlando Smith. His cruiser cam was working before and after the accident, but not during. And it was the exact same technical issue that happened when he shot and killed a drug suspect named Dantes O'Neill last November. The camera worked before and after, but not during the shooting. Police told us the cameras are virtually tamper-proof. Officer Smith was given a Medal of Valor for his actions, telling us then,
I couldn't retreat. I was there. I was in the middle of it, and I had to handle it.
But now, parents of those involved in both cases are asking questions.
And for them to honor him with awards and medals or whatnot for killing my baby, that right there, I won't stand for that.
Nico Neal is Dantes O'Neill's mother, represented by attorney Eric Dieters, and now so is Natalie's mother, Brenda Cole. She says because her daughter had an addiction problem, her case gets less attention.
They call them undesirables. I don't think they get justice.
And while Natalie doesn't want revenge, she does think Officer Smith should face punishment.
A long time. Because I'm going to be messed up for a while from this, and I didn't deserve this.
Now, Natalie has no idea how long her recovery will take. Dieters expects to have that lawsuit filed no later than Monday, Sheree.
Brian Hamrick reporting for us tonight. Brian, thank you. We should also mention Officer Orlando Smith has been on the force for more than 20 years. He received the Medal of Valor following that shooting last year, and he was also named Officer of the Year for the entire state of Ohio last year.